You know, I am a cook by trade, and of course, I'm better cook than I'm a painter, I think. But there are similarities in it, you know. Certainly, of course, when you cook something, you eat it, it disappeared, and all you have left is memory. The painting stays there forever. And when I look at some of the painting that I did 30 years ago, I know that I could never do that again. I know that I don't even know where I had that idea or I could do it because I don't feel the same way at all. However, in the process of cooking, at some point, especially in a restaurant, you know, there is an automatic, very intuitive process in the cooking process. You're doing a sauteed sweetbread or something in a restaurant. And you add something, you taste, you add, you taste, you add, you taste to bring it to a certain level. It's very intuitive. You don't even think about it. You do it. And if you have the same order 10 minutes later, you do it, certainly not exactly in the same way, but eventually to get to the same result, the same taste when you're satisfied. You cannot, when you cook, look for those products. They have to be in front of you. And likewise in painting, I cannot paint and start saying, maybe I need a little bit of a yellow cadmium there or a blue indigo and go and get the tube. And no, you cannot do that. You have to have those painting in front of you, just like I have a different type of garlic, onion, all that in front of me. And I take one, a touch here, a touch there. It's almost automatic. There is that intuitive process in cooking for me as well as in painting.